Of Saxon down the line. It's a good bit of play from Runcorn there, as Saxon has it now. He's got Andrew Tague on his back and he's just been bundled to the floor by the big, bald, shiny head of Andrew Tague. Kyle Walker. Well, back on the way now as Short looks to play the ball forward, but it's in behind now towards the runner, Sefton Gonzalez. Gonzalez into the box and he tucks it under Bailey Passon. It was a quick free kick from Runcorn and it just, nobody was on the same page. Clitheroe nick it and roll it into the feet of Gonzalez, and there's only one thing that's going to happen at that point, Jack, isn't there?
Yeah, that's what he does. What he does, he always scores against us, and he's done it again.
Yeah, going on the tunnel. Do you know what? I'm not. I don't even care. We haven't got a tunnel today. I don't want to mess the radio up. It was a good finish from Sefton Gonzalez. Once he latches onto the end of a loose ball like that, he's never going to not score.
Draw.
One corner, nicked it back here as Saxon drives into the box. It's a square ball towards Kieran Napper. Napper takes a touch. It's a great block in the end as Ben Collins was tracking back, but it's back towards Barrett. Barrett hits from distance, but into the hands of Hakan Burton. It was a good strike from Sam Barrett, but Runcorn with at least a half chance there, Jack. Yeah. Now with Hakan Burton just outside his own penalty area. He looks long towards Sefton Gonzalez, who's beaten in the air by Sean O'Mahony. He does well, actually, to get it back towards Bailey Passon, but Passon can only hook it out for a corner kick. He was just on the stretch there into space now. It's a good run there as Welsh plays one wide towards Napper. It's a good ball now. Kieran Napper drives into the clear open area. It's a square ball, but only into the hands of Burton. But Runcorn have really turned the turbo on since going 1-0 down, Jack. The area now, it's taken short into Jack's Welsh. Welsh then swings it in towards the middle. It's onto the foot of Will Sachs now. He turns and shoots, but it's easy into the hands of Hakan Burton. But it's definitely been a much better sort of 7 minutes since the goal. Runcorn free kick here as Kay takes it into the feet of James Short. He crosses left footed in towards the middle. Malloy goes up, but there's a foul in there for a push by Ollie Malloy, and it's going to be a Clitheroe free kick. But now onto the chest of Richie Baker. He's beaten to it by Saxon, but Wilkin wins it back for Clitheroe as he looks to bring it over halfway. He rolls it forward into the feet of Dent. Dent then to Azram, who drives down this right-hand side, gives it back towards Vernon Parney. Parney with some tricky footwork to go past Jack Welsh. It's going to be a free kick to Clitheroe right on the edge of the penalty area. To swing this in towards Bailey Passant's goal as Baker's over. It is left for Parney. Parney shoots and it's onto the crossbar, but onto the top of the crossbar more than anything, and over for a goal kick played by Runcorn. It's just been the last part as Saxon now looks to drive into a space, shoots from the edge of the box and in to the back of the net by Will Saxon. He tucks it home with his weaker foot. The ball was rolled into a pocket of space on the edge of the penalty area. Saxon turns, sets himself and curls one into the corner to put us all square, and Jeff and Pete have fists raised in the air on the gantry here. Jack Walsh.
Yeah, an excellent finish there by Will Saxon. He's done terrifically to hit that, especially on his weaker side, and put Runcorn back in the game at 1-1.
It was a lovely finish from Will Saxon. And just that, I said Anthony Knockhart, the former Leicester man. Fulham have also scored with Munez to put them 2-0 up against Bournemouth. But Runcorn level pegging here as Will Saxon curls one into the corner. We've definitely scored. Doesn't matter if it's gone out or not, as the ball is now with Gonzalez. He looks to go into the penalty area, and he's still got hold of the ball, Stefan Gonzalez. He's managed to get a shot, but it's cleared off the line by Lewis Doyle. Excellent defending, and Stefan Gonzalez has got his head in his hands because he can't understand how he hasn't put Clitheroe back into the lead there.
Yeah.
I wonder why that hasn't gone out from football pages then. So Runcorn now trying to break as they win it back with Ollie Molloy. Molloy does well to muscle Sefton Gonzalez out of it and finds Napper. Napper cuts inside his man onto his left foot and rolls it into Welsh. Welsh now looking to drive forward as he's got Molloy wide. He finds Saxon. Saxon with a lovely little turn. Gets inside the box. Now Will Saxon. It's a square ball towards O'Neill. And he tucks it home to put Runcorn 2-1 off. And he gets his first goal for the club. And that was a brilliant team goal. Make sure you check that one out, because that was an excellent bit of football from Runcorn Linnets there. It was a lovely break there as Welsh rolled it wide towards Will Saxon. It was a lovely smart little Cruyff turn on the edge of the penalty area to get away from his man, and then he unselfishly rolls it square to Mackenzie O'Neill to tuck home to put Runcorn 2-1 up.
We're doing our best. So the ball is wide to Azram now. He cuts inside. His ball is a poor one. It only finds Molloy now. We're going attacking 3v3 now as Molloy shoots some distance in. Oh, what a goal! Holly Molloy has just stuck that in the top onion bag from about 35 yards. Kind of ridiculous. He just picks the ball up, drives into space, and out of absolutely nowhere, smashes it into the top bin past the desperate dive of Hakan Burton. What a finish that is, Jack.
That was absolutely unbelievable. As soon as he hit it, you knew exactly where that ball was going as it flew top corner. What a goal. No keeper on the planet was saving that effort.
Wow, what a strike from Ollie Molloy to put Runcorn 3-1 up. It was an unbelievable goal. Three contenders for goal of the season in one game here.
Unbelievable, Sam.
Where we are, where, Jack?
Where are we next week? Staley Bridge?
Staley Bridge,
sorry.
It was just a test for you. Yeah. I knew that. I didn't. As Saxon is left in a heap on the floor as he's just been bundled into by Will Hall there as they both went up for the header. Will Hall just a little bit overzealous in his attempt to win the header. And it's going to be a Runcorn free kick just inside their own half. Saxon does well to get there then. Doyle nicks one round the corner towards Barrett. Barrett's then bundled to the ground by Ross Dent. It's going to be a Runcorn free kick.
Pickford has put Newcastle 2 up.
That could be a big one in the push for promotion as the ball is now with Saxon. He looks to face up Andrew Tate, takes him into the penalty area. Will Saxon back towards O'Neill. First time shot, it's cleared by Lancaster, back to O'Neill. Good feet inside the penalty area, gets it back to Saxon. Saxon looking to shoot and takes it home to make it 4-1 to Runcorn. It's his second of the day and Runcorn scored. It was lovely feet inside the box from Mackenzie O'Neill. He worked a little bit of space, rolls it back to Saxon, who just calmly takes his time and rolls it home to make it Runcorn 4, Clitheroe 1.
I tell you what, Runcorn has
got the ball away from Ollie Molloy, but his clearance is only as far as Mackenzie O'Neill. O'Neill left the penalty area, shoots, but saved by Hakan Burton. There was been
put it over it.
Baker's corner kick is going to be an in-swinger towards Bailey Passon. It's all the way to the back post. Domain reaches header and Passon actually, I think, managed to get a hand to that to push it around the post and out for another corner kick. But Roos was wide open at the back post there.
No, but only.
And get some vital minutes under his belt.
Oh, the gate is 5-3-1. It's important that my man had that. Obviously, he's broke last week. Will Saxon's been absolutely clattered into there. And there's a bit of handbags
over on that far side. Tom is fully zoomed in to tell us what's going on, but there was a heavy, heavy challenge there on Will Saxon.
Who's on the bench with the
Roof. Roof gets the boat back towards Carney now. His left foot delivery is towards Gonzalez, but passing is there to gather brilliantly at the back stick. That's a lovely piece of goalkeeping from the Runcorn man. All off her own telly, which means she's at home as an Everton fan watching Liverpool.
But also,
oh, I was there.
Oh, was. Alan, yeah. But she is also listening to us, yeah, as well. And that's the dedication I want.
Come on. Well, now we've killed a gap. He shoots Burton, saves it! And it's tapped home by Eden Guns! At the back post, it was a shot from Kieran Napper, it was saved by Hakan Burton, and all Eden Guns had to do was just roll it into an empty net to make it Runcorn 5, Clitheroe 1.
other than the same wandering fish. Lucas Paul 4-0, wasn't he?
5-0.
Oh, no, so Lucas still in this one. For now, there's still 5 minutes of football to play.
Yeah, who? In memory of Arthur Christian. There's a bit of afters in the box between Tague and Brook again. I think that's an ongoing saga for the rest of the game here. Brook again. There's going to be a foul against Andrew Teague on Ryan Brook, and there's all sorts of actors here. And put the net. Teague's just gone flying in. It looked like he headbutted Eden Guns. He's off. He is off Andrew Teague. He went flying into Eden Guns there. And Teague has been sent off. And so has Eden Guns. I don't know why Guns has been sent off, but it looked like Teague went flying in with a headbutt there on Eden Guns. So Guns came on, scored, he got sent off. Andrew Teague has been sent off as well. I don't know what goes in the middle of all of it. So delivery in towards the back and headed down by Gonzalez, picked up by Roos, it's in towards the middle of the box, and Bailey passes there to gather well. Ryan Brook is just a nuisance. I was Omani now towards James Shaw. Shaw down the line towards Doyle. And there is the full-time whistle here at the Apex Saxy Stadium. And it's finished with a 4-1 victory to the home side. An excellent performance. Two goals from Will Saxon, a goal from Ollie Molloy, and a goal from the new boy, Mackenzie O'Neill. And that late one from
you forgot that about
the dot from Eden Guns.
Yeah, it was a 5-1 victory, not 4-1. That's how the main the sound didn't even know where the goal to come from. But yeah, Runcorn went behind early in the game, and in a situation where I think Runcorn the last couple of weeks it looked like we'd struggle from that point forward. But no, we stepped up, equalised, then saw a chance for Clitheroe, cleared off the line, then went up the other end, took a 2-1 lead, then come out second half and just totally dominated the game. Three goals in the second half, a 5-1 victory. I think we've got fully deserving the win. I think Clitheroe may feel a 5-1 was a bit harsh, but Runcorn was just more clinical on the day. And as we always say, Sammy, it's how many goals you score that matter at the end of the day.
Yeah, a very big thank you to you, Jack, for joining me in the commentary box. As always, a very big thank you to you guys at home for your patience. Promise you, we'll be back firing on all cylinders very, very shortly. But for today, a 5-1 victory puts Runcorn into glorious football heaven for the evening. And we will see you next week at Stalybridge Celtic. Good night.